So the idea behind the book is there's this kind of official third day story that if you've known third day and our music for a while, you kind of probably know a little bit about it. That I met Matt Powell, who's our singer. We met in outside of Atlanta way back in 19, a long time ago, way back when the earth was still cooling in the early 90s, Matt Powell and started this band. And then we started the band, and then, you know, we started touring, we got signed by a record company, and we traveled all over the place, we've been all over the world, and 25 years later, here we are, and it's been such a blessing to be a part of that. So that's kind of the official third day story. If you want to know more about it, there have been articles, there's Wikipedia pages about it. Y'all feel free to go look it up, knock yourself out. But I'm here tonight to talk about this other story that I really haven't shared much, really, if at all. And to the point, like, if I've known somebody for like a year, we'll just be talking, and then in passing, I'll say something about, oh yeah, you know, after I had my accident. They're like, what accident? I was like, oh, you don't know, I got hit by a truck. And they're like, whoa, what? Why didn't you tell me about that, like, first thing? Why didn't you lead with that? But yeah, so that's kind of the story, and I'm not giving it. In fact, what I'm going to do, since I kind of gave it in sort of lecture form this morning, I'm going to actually read for you, if you guys are okay with that. I'm going to read a couple of passages for you guys tonight. I'm going to get the stool. If you got a prop, you know, just really use it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to read right now. This is the very first. This is the introduction of the book. It's real quick. It's going to take like 3 minutes. And by the way, so this concert tonight, I have a very short attention span. I don't know if you guys are like this. So if you start to drift off a little bit, just know that I'm going to be telling some stories. And if you get bored with the stories, know that there's music coming. I'm going to be doing some music in a little bit. If you get bored with the music, know that there's going to be another story coming in a while. So if we work together, we're going to get through this. It's going to be good. So this, I'm going to read like the first about 2.5 pages of the book for you. So here we go. I've heard people say that sometimes your brain will shut down just before traumatic experiences, and you won't remember anything that happened. That may be true, but it surely wasn't the case for me. I remember every detail. I looked up and saw headlights. There was no time to react. The truck was moving too fast. I remember my body's impact at the front of it. Swept and thrown upward, I bounced off the top of the truck like a rag doll and spun up in the air. The street light above took over, and as the focus of my vision, the truck's headlights had been before. The light turned in circles in the morning darkness. For a moment, I felt nothing. I was completely separated from Earth. Then I hit asphalt. Adrenaline is a funny thing. I didn't feel myself making contact with the road so much as I was simply aware of it. Like I wasn't living this myself, but only watching it happen to somebody else. Because of that, I don't know exactly what part of me hit the road, but later the pain and lacerations on my face and right arm let me know that these areas had absorbed the main force of the impact. Hey, stop! Somebody yelled as the truck sailed through the intersection of Hurt Road and Powder Springs Road. The driver slammed his brakes, screeching the truck to a halt. Wait a minute, I thought to myself. I'm still alive. Aren't you supposed to die if you get hit by a truck? Emboldened by the adrenaline racing through me and numbed by the shock of the accident, I decided to attempt standing up, but my right leg refused to cooperate. I slumped back to the ground in the middle of the road. I heard footsteps. A man from the nearby gas station ventured into the middle of the intersection and knelt down beside me. Are you okay? Say something. I'm okay. I think my leg is bleeding. He looked down at my leg. Yeah, your leg looks a little banged up, but help is on the way. He was trying to put a positive spin on the situation, but I could tell from his face that he was looking at something gruesome. I began to shiver. Even though it still gets pretty warm in Georgia in October, the mornings can be pretty chilly. I was supposed to be going to school for band practice. We were scheduled to perform in a big marching band competition that night, and I'd really looked forward to it. My plans for today had obviously changed. I don't know how long it took. It seemed like a couple of minutes and an eternity at the same time. Paramedics were soon on the scene. Sirens filled the air, and the bright lights of an ambulance flickered and bounced off the side of the quick drift, which was the gas station, wasn't it? The gas station. Two guys in uniform hopped out of the ambulance. One came running up to me while his partner stayed behind to prepare a stretcher. Even though I was still in shock, I figured an attempt at comedy might be in order. You guys want to buy some donuts? The paramedic tended to me chuckled, then it was all business. Hey, buddy, are you okay? Can you tell me your name and where you are? Routine questions. In accident situations. My name is Mark, I said, and I'm on the road. said, that's really what I said. I said, hey, my name's Mark, and I'm on the road. And I had no idea that I was almost like speaking this prophecy about what my life was going to be like, that I was going to spend like most of my adult life, you know, on the road traveling with a band. And so it's just cool to see how God's dreams that he has for us are so much bigger than the dreams we have for ourselves. And so that's a little taste of what the book's about. I'm going to read probably two or three more passages later on tonight. So if you get bored with the music, that's coming. So